Anna. So great to finally meet you. I've seen some of your online presentations in the product team. So one of the things that I'm talking to people about is the importance of community. And really what that looks like with, you know, as we've been living through this pandemic and we've all been virtual for a very long time. What are you looking forward to most in the next year or so?
Oh, yeah. I mean, assuming the next year or so means we're all going to start seeing each other again, I'm really looking forward. Even this week, it's been awesome to see people, meet people I've never actually met before until now, or re-meet them. I think just that community vibe is just missing. And one example, actually, at the past Data Summit last week, I joined the community zone, and that was the closest that I've kind of felt to that experience, because everyone got close. I got to see Ben and Catherine and people from all over the world, and just chat about random stuff as opposed to always talking about the tech. I mean, the tech's important, but other things as well, and I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah. So, you know, you mentioned kind of the other side of community, not just, you know, a professional life, but how do you disconnect? How do you get away from work?
I think the best way to get away from work is to not have cell phone service. So,
okay. Is that possible? Where do you go to not have cell phone service?
So recently I did a backpacking trip in the Grand Canyon. No cell service there. Like to go skiing where there's no cell service. I don't bring my phone when I ski, so
awesome.
It's enough for no cell service. But I think disconnecting is really important. I didn't start in the data community. I started over in services, and then I went to the AI platform. I was not a data person. But they don't have the same sense of community. And so I think you don't realize what it is until, like, I didn't know that I was missing this, if that makes sense, right? The community, the seeing people, the following people around on what they're doing, what they're writing about. I think you learn a lot, you grow a lot. I don't know. I feel like this is the best area of tech that I've been in my very limited career because of the community.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and, you know, I think a lot of other companies, a lot of other vendors, you know, have events and conferences and things like this, but the community surrounding the Microsoft, particularly the database platform, is so genuine. And, you know, why is that? What is it about the Microsoft data platform community that makes it so unique?
You know, it's interesting. I don't know how it happened. For whatever reason, we have this wonderful community of people who love SQL Server. And for some reason, I think that's where it started.
Yeah.
I wasn't here, so you probably could comment more. But from there, it's just, I don't know. It's a really weird thing that everyone connects and people care and they follow up. I've seen multiple instances where different members of the community from other places of the world, they meet up. They're in each other's weddings. Like, honestly, when I first joined this community, that was just weird. I had no idea, like, people had so many friends from their work lives.
Yeah. Well, and we're very genuinely a family.
Yeah.
You know, I think that this community crosses over between our professional and our personal lives. And there's not a real strong division between, you know, what we do when we're at work and, you know, this wonderful community that we have, you know, that, you know, at conferences like this and other events and folks like Buck and Karen and Tom and, you know, all of the wonderful people that are here.
Yeah, no, it's so nice to see people that you see online, and you see them in person, and they're as nice as you think they were, and they help you. And I think, like, everyone's just so willing to help and be kind and in whatever way they can. So I've certainly seen it on my end. And, you know, you come in kind of as an outsider because I didn't come through the community. I came through Microsoft. But everyone's been really great and really nice from when I would say, like, came out with the community and SQL Bits back in 2019.
What's that?
So it's been a lot of fun since then.
What's that?
Okay. All right. What sessions are you presenting while you're here?
You know, he's not the real BW.
I did a demo and Bob session where I ran on stage. I'm not sure if Bob liked that or not, but he's around. And
he's still here.
you know, that's the key. If you really want to get Bob, you just surprise him during a keynote with something.
You really did surprise me this morning. Yes, I had no idea.
For context, I did a fitness app demo, so I ran to the stage instead of preparing for my.
And I didn't know you were going to do this. Really?
I'm sorry that I missed this.
Yes.
Sounds like it was very entertaining.
Surprise the keynote speaker. That's one way to become friends with the keynote speaker. Not.
You don't have to insult their age to be funny. You can do other things.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Anna.
Yeah,
I appreciate your time.